The next phase of our project is to come up with a population estimate. We're going to put bear hare snares in the woods.
So we are setting up hare snares to capture hare samples from black bears moving across the landscape. This hare snare is basically a single strand of barbed wire that we wrap around three or maybe four trees, and it creates a corral. In the center of that corral, we put a pile of dead or decaying logs, which gets a half liter of fish oil dumped on top of it. And then those perimeter trees around that hare snare are misted with anise root oil as a scent lure. And so any bears moving throughout that area will pick up that scent and hopefully come into that snare. And when they do get to that snare, they usually either go under or over that wire. And when they do that, the barbs pull off a sample of that hare, which will stay on that wire until we come back to collect it.
Well, from that hare, we can actually get DNA and identify that animal as an individual. We can identify the sex of that animal and perhaps even the age.
We have 378 snares that we've distributed in areas where we have recorded black bear sightings. It's a 20-year database of sightings throughout the state, and we've allocated our snares to those areas where we know bears are moving or could be moving. Next year, we will replicate this hare snare experiment in the southeastern region of the state, where we will set up between 350 and 400 hare snares, where we will have GPS-collared bears throughout this area as well, and place the remote cameras here. We're actually trapping bears in that region right now in preparation for next year's field season.
From all our hare snares, we're going to come up with a population estimate. We're also going to know the sex ratio of males to females, which is important to know. When we're through with this project, we're going to have a pretty good idea of what's out there and how many bears we have and where they are.